Ευχαριστούμε που ήρθατε στη σημερινή εκδήλωση με τίτλο «Δικτυωμένες εξεγέρσεις». Η εκδήλωση είναι μια διοργάνωση των περιοδικών Container και Republic. Να σας πω πολύ γρήγορα μερικά διαδικαστικά, δηλαδή πώς θα προχωρήσουμε από εδώ και πέρα, όπως είπα, όσο πιο γρήγορα γίνεται. Έχουμε σήμερα 4 παρουσιάσεις, οι οποίες θα είναι αρκετά σύντομες, 20 λεπτά maximum κάθε μία, και μετά θα ανοίξουμε το... Θα δώσουμε το βήμα σε όποιον θέλει να μιλήσει για συζήτηση και μεταξύ των συμμετεχόντων στο πάνελ και ζητώντας και τις δικές σας απόψεις. Όλες οι παρουσιάσεις θα γίνουν στα αγγλικά και θα υπάρξει διαδοχική μετάφραση από τον Κωνσταντίνο Παπαδάκη, τον οποίο ευχαριστούμε πολύ που είναι μαζί μας σήμερα στα ελληνικά. Εδώ πέρα σταματάω τα ελληνικά και αρχίζω λοιπόν και εγώ προς χάρη, ας πούμε, της αγγλικής, του αγγλικού καθεστώτος, του αγγλικού γλωσσικού καθεστώτος της εκδήλωσης, να αρχίσω να μιλάω στα αγγλικά, παρουσιάζοντας ομιλητές. Και θες να με... Όχι. Και θα μεταφράσω τον εαυτό μου και στα ελληνικά. Για να μην σε κουράσω. We are very glad to have here 4 speakers. Three coming from North Africa, and one from Greece, Belgium and Greece. Okay. I want to say two words for the event. The event is called Network Revolts and involves the recent revolutions and ongoing revolutions in North Africa. Just before coming here, I had the radio on and heard something completely different. And then a song came onto my mind, a song that was written in 1971. This song is sung and written by Gilles Scott-Heron, and it's called The Revolution Will Not Be Televised. The song was written in 1971 and related to the civil rights movement in the U.S., mainly in the anti-Vietnam War movement there, the worldwide anti-war Vietnam movement. It's interesting that this song became very popular, okay, but its slogan, the revolution will not be televised, became then repeatedly used by academics, semi-academics, social movement, proponents around the world, and it was supposed to show how, you know, the authentic revolution is something that is not related to the dominant media of the time, the television, how the authentic revolution is something that cannot be encountered by the dominant media of the time, the television. It's also interesting that although this slogan, that evolution, the revolution will not be televised, was used in this context, in a social movement kind of revolutionary context, that the song itself is far more sarcastic than this. I mean, I remember that the song ends with Gilles Scott-Heron, after he recounted a series of events that characterize these authentic revolutions and that cannot be televised, says at the end something like, okay, the revolution will happen this way, that way, the other way, but until then, niggers will continue to party and bullshit and party and bullshit. And the song ends there. Now, I think a similar slogan to Gilles Scott-Heron, the revolution will not be televised, for our times, is a slogan that came out of the revolts in North Africa. And this was the slogan, the revolution will not be twittered. This is a slogan that has no song to portray it yet, to make it into music, but it has been repeatedly used by analysts, activists, academics around the world. In a way, the event springs from this slogan, to answer the question, if there is a question, to say yes or no that the revolution is Twittered or will not be Twittered, but to pose some questions around the slogan, to see whether the uses of new media during the Arab revolts and the way these revolutions evolved change the way we think about, on the one hand, revolution, and on the other hand, new media. I will shut up, but I haven't translated anything. I'm sorry. We continue with our first speaker. Our first speaker is Lina Benmeni. Lina comes from Tunisia. She is a Twitterer and a blogger, a very famous now blogger. She has a blog, A Tunisian Girl, and her blog and her activism, both online and on the ground in Tunisia, has been awarded the Blog of the Year award of the Deutsche Welle for 2011. I pass on the word to Lina.